Dark matter explained in 10 minutes and why it doesn't exist. My name is Demian and this is Growing Together. Let's just start with what we observe that makes scientists believe in dark matter, or as I like to call it, puff. The magic dragon. The orbital rotational speeds of all galaxies in the universe are moving much, much faster than they should. The universe is not behaving. All the orbits of all galaxies run faster when we compare the matter that we see to our theoretical models. On one side, we have what Newton and Einstein tell us about how these galaxies should be moving, and on the other side, it is what we actually see. It's like we're watching them in fast camera. Entire galaxies also orbit around each other in giant galaxy clusters, and the same thing is happening with them. Nobody wants to follow the rules. They're also acting like a Charlie Chaplin film. This is how they should move, and this is what we observe. Side note, this is for the scientists. If you're not a scientist, bear with me or skip this part. It's a short blurb. There are three other observations related to this. The first is in cosmic microwave background radiation. The second is in gravitational lensing. I'll briefly address them at the end of this video, but you're gonna have to dig a little deeper on your own if you're not familiar with them. And the third, the 2011 Nobel Prize awarded in physics that infers dark matter from our observations of supernovas. I'll address that now. They assumed that the cosmological principle applies to small distances, and it doesn't. Here's the paper that proves it, which is widely ignored in mainstream science, and also proves that the evidence for dark matter in supernovas disappears. If you're a scientist who loves to tell the science god that they have no clothes on, you'll love this paper. Now, let's get back to the misfit universe that we live in. It's not behaving like it should. It wants to move in fast camera. Why do our theoretical models not match what we observe? The scientific community today mostly agrees that dark matter exists. This dark matter has never been directly observed or proven in any experiments or their theoretical particles observed in particle accelerators. Furthermore, as the James Webb Telescope is discovering these massive distant galaxies where they should not exist, our entire understanding of dark matter for the formation of our universe no longer makes sense. These distant galaxies should not be so fully formed if dark matter exists. So how did we come up with dark matter in the first place? We can't really blame science for their assumptions. It's a logical way to come up with a solution. All scientists did to account for the faster motion of galaxies was to take Einstein's equations and simply added the matter side of the equation by approximately 85% so that the theoretical models match what we actually observe. And it works. What this implies is that the matter that we see accounts for only 15% of what's out there, and dark matter accounts for 85% of the stuff that is out there. That means that all galaxies out there and galaxy clusters are mostly this invisible stuff. Not stars, not gas, not plasma, not black holes. But we've never observed dark matter directly. So, if dark matter doesn't exist, something else is causing everything to move faster. And what could that be? Did you know that Einstein's theories of relativity tells us that your movement in time relative to the rest of the universe can change based on your acceleration, velocity, and gravitational field that surrounds you? In other words, things can change in their movement through time. If you don't believe me, learn about general and special relativity. As counterintuitive as what I said sounds, it's been proven and is how things work. What else might cause the time of the orbits of all galaxies and galaxy clusters to move faster? Pause the video now and try to figure it out. If you guessed because they're moving faster in time, I think you're getting there. But that's a bold claim. We have to explain why. New theories known as modified gravity theories are making their way into mainstream science, saying just that. Unless we don't understand the laws of gravity, I think this is also highly unlikely. Perhaps you thought because we are moving slower in time relative to the rest of the universe. If you guessed that, I think you super nailed it, because then we don't need the entire universe to break the laws of gravity. All we need is the sun in orbit around a black hole partner. Or, I thought about this yesterday, the sun accelerating towards a rogue black hole it encountered in its orbit around the galaxy. Let me explain. One reason for time dilation is higher acceleration and velocity of matter. The faster you move and the more you accelerate, the slower you move in time relative to the rest of the universe. Furthermore, the more gravity that surrounds you, the slower you move in time relative to the rest of the universe. But if you're moving slower in time, you don't realize it because it's happening beneath the subatomic level. That's not science fiction. That is basic relativity. So what's causing us to move fast and increase our gravitational field? Most of the stars that we see in the night sky are binary star systems. We've also observed X-ray binary star systems. That's a star in orbit around a black hole. These are much harder to spot because we know about them only in systems where the black hole is feeding on the star because they're really close. There could be a lot more X-ray binary star systems that we don't know of if the black holes are not feeding. Stars in nature do not like being alone. You've got traditional marriages, that's two stars orbiting around each other. You've got polyamory stars, three stars, four stars, five stars orbiting around each other. You've got sad stars still attached to their dead lovers, which is what I believe happened to the sun's partner a long time ago, possibly before there was life on Earth. Or, as I just realized yesterday, so I'm revamping my entire paper because of what I realized yesterday, is that the sun is accelerating towards a rogue black hole it encountered in its orbit around the galaxy. And this rogue black hole or black hole partner is very close to the sun. When an orbit is highly elliptical, there is a phase in the orbit where the star heads towards periapsis. The star accelerates in this phase of the orbit. The same thing would happen if the sun encountered a rogue black hole. Since we are close to it, we are experiencing a stronger gravitational field by the increasing proximity to this black hole. And this is what's causing us as observers on this tiny little planet to observe the universe moving faster in time. Here's some of Einstein's field equations that explains what we would actually observe if we're slowing down in time because of the sun's orbit around a black hole with different masses. We observe what we actually observe if we're slowing down in time, and here's the math to prove it. A black hole with five solar masses would be extremely small in size, 9 miles in radius. That's about 120 times smaller than the moon and smaller than a lot of asteroids, and it reflects no light. That explains why we haven't found it. Also, gravitational lensing would not be observed if we are close to a black hole. The effects of gravitational lensing, because of our proximity, causes us to observe gravitational lensing magnification instead, which means that everything would be moving away from us and accelerating, as we observe with dark energy as well. This black hole could also be 1,000 times larger in mass, or even 1,000,000 times larger in mass. I've done the models. Theoretically, anything is possible beyond a black hole of 5 solar masses. Check out my predictions for the Matthew hypothesis. If it's correct, all of them will come true. If we're in this orbit, or the sun is accelerating towards a rogue black hole, galaxies and galaxy clusters are also going to accelerate over time, because we're slowing down more and more. Now, I'm going to briefly touch back on what I mentioned earlier. If you don't know about cosmic microwave background radiation, you've got to look it up. Our indirect interpretation within CMBR for dark matter can also be interpreted as an increase in time and not in matter. CMBR are just photons. So that means that if we're in this orbit, or if we're heading towards a rogue black hole, the photons from CMBR will also be redshifted over time. The same thing happens with gravitational lensing. It all depends on how we interpret the data, and here's the math to prove it. Gravitational lensing is also distorted, which explains the unexplained gravitational lensing for distant galaxy clusters. And here's the math to prove it. I wanted to address them both in this video because I want scientists to not simply check off the Matthew hypothesis based on their knowledge on what these things are. You have to read the fine print. In my next video, I'm going to destroy dark energy. Our slowing down in time and the increasing gravitational field all around us also accounts for our observations in dark energy. This hypothesis solves both problems by adding an element that we know exists in our universe without the need to change gravity for the entire universe or add Puff the Magic Dragon in the entire universe. It explains everything by this orbit. Check out my other video on precession. That's another local observation. I'm going to also make a video on the mystery of the acceleration of solar wind, which is also another observation that confirms that what this hypothesis says is true. Be good to yourselves. Be good to each other. And I'll see you next time.